In the last lecture we downloaded Inkscape version 1.2. Inkscape version 1.3, however, has big improvements, like the Shape Builder tool. So I downloaded the latest development version from the Inkscape website by going to Download, Latest Development Version. This version may still have some bugs in it, but I find it already very stable. When you open Inkscape for the first time, you're welcomed by a quick setup screen. You can do some settings here, but you can also do that later. I downloaded Inkscape version 1.3, which will soon be the current version. If you don't want to go through the tabs, you can exit the welcome screen at the top right. And when you press Escape, the welcome screen will not show up anymore when you open Inkscape. Now let's look at how you can customize the user interface. I will do this by showing how I created mine. At the right, I have fill and stroke, layers, path effects, and the swatches panel. To add a panel, click on the arrow. I can change the order of the panels, and I can drag a panel to another place. To get more room, I can collapse the panels by clicking on the three dots. And I can give the panels below more room by dragging the three dots. In the document properties, I have made the canvas, called desk, darker, by setting lightness to 30. Then I went to File, Save Template. I called it A4 Dark Desk, and selected, Set as Default Template. In the View menu, I hid the commands bar, and the palette colors that normally show at the bottom. I also prefer to work in full screen mode, to get maximum space in the height. Under Edit, Preferences, Windows, I chose, Remember Last Windows Geometry. This means that when I change something in my UI, these changes are saved. Here you can also choose, to see the welcome screen when you start Inkscape. Under Theming, I have the high contrast inverse theme, and multicolor icons. You can change the colors of these icons if you want. And if you have a high resolution screen, under Toolbars, you can increase the size of the icons at the left, and at the top. In the next lecture, we will start creating shapes.